Where's the American ambassador? Police. Papers.
Here's a bulletin from the Ministry of the Interior. This evening, as he was leaving a club in Paris where he'd been dining, Richard Poindexter, the United States ambassador to France, was kidnapped by an unidentified group of armed men. The kidnappers opened fire on the ambassador's companions, seriously wounding a chauffeur, a French policeman, was also critically wounded, and another one killed. The government is determined to identify and apprehend the perpetrators of this outrage in the shortest possible time. The news has already evoked a vigorous reaction in official circles in Washington, although as you know, it is only 6 o'clock in the morning in the American capital.
The preliminary findings of the police suggest strongly that this attack is the work of fanatic elements acting deliberately or through sheer folly who wish to weaken public order and security at any price. The government will not hesitate to take the most vigorous action against them unless they abandon their plans.
I drink to uncouth desperados! So I'm a fool. This operation is stupid and it's pointless.
I wouldn't be astonished if they killed their hostage.
Wouldn't the Americans wouldn't be astonished at that?
My dear Goemel, you're on the police. Don't worry about foreign policy.
It is obvious the state opposes terrorism, but it prefers terrorism to revolution.
Between revolution and death, the state has chosen death. Fire! Fire! Fire!
Trap for those who want revolt, and I fell into it.